connection to Rod Morris. It's about my grandpa. I was named after him. And it's funny because I played this little show one time. It was a live radio show called Southern Exposure in Brevard, North Carolina, at a little coffee house called Essence of Time. And they recorded it also. And it was put on by the White Squirrel, WSQL, a little local AM radio station in Brevard. So people start telling me, man, they're playing the heck out of your song. They're playing it all the time. And so they picked that song, this song up, The Legend of Rod Morris. And it was hilarious because a friend of mine, he had got one of his songs picked up and they played it in Colorado, some radio station in Colorado. And he got a check from BMI for a dollar. But now check this out.
So that much money.
They sent me a check. They had played my song so much on the White Squirrel, and when I got the check and I got the how many times they had played it, they have all the stuff. They had played my song 174 times on the White Squirrel, and I made $10.44. And this guy was my arch rival, so I beat him by about $9.44. Anyway, he's so this is The Legend of Rod Morris. Grandpa Rod used to burn his toast, scrape it with a butter knife. He said, that's the way I like it. Pass the jelly, everything is alright. Rod and Myrtle, they had a good life. They worked hard for everything they had. Myrtle gave birth to four pretty girls and one boy. That was my dad, but I don't really remember my grandpa. He died before I was five. My dad has told me some story, so his memory is still alive. I remember as a young boy crying myself to sleep, praying to the good Lord. My grandpa was so deep. They tell me I'm just like him, and that makes me feel. So I live with the legend, Rodden Horse. I've got his name, and I've got his ways. And I know someday, when I get to heaven, I'll see him face to face.
Nice.
They hadn't seen each other in years. So Don decided that he was going to come to North Carolina and see us, see my dad. So we went and picked him up at the airport, and they immediately started talking about old times. And it was so hilarious. They were like, they were about 70, and they were like, now what, huh? You know, it was hilarious. They couldn't hear each other hardly. And I wrote this song in the back seat listening to them talk. And I just want to preface this by saying, I haven't drank in 20 years, okay? And this song is about drinking and hell raising, because that's what they did, so.
Hell that we raised, looking back, seems quite fun.
Catch a greyhound one way. Yeah.